Okay, so two agenda items. I got 5 hours with you. 2.5 hours today, 2.5 hours on Thursday. 5 hours, right? Okay, good. Two agenda items, and for both of them, I would require your 100% committed partnership. Okay, cannot get done in 5 hours otherwise. All right, okay, good. So one is for today, and the today, the one what we're going to be doing is, you get to work on you, your favorite person. Come on, I mean, let's be straight about it. Who's your favorite person? Yeah, of course, obviously, right? Okay, that's your favorite person. But sometimes, you know, when I say you, and I'm going to, you know, look in this direction and say, it's your job, you usually think it's your neighbor, not you. So just so that it is clear, let us do some very simple exercise. Please put your hand up, right hand up. Okay, now use your left hand to follow me. That, when I say you, that's the person I'm talking about, the person in your chair, the person in your body. Touch yourself, make sure you're here. All right, very good. So what we're going to be doing is working on you. And I'm not going to be doing it, you're going to be doing it. Okay, I'm just going to create a conversation, create some inquiries, inside of which you will actually begin to take a look at yourself in a way which is normally not asked of you. In a normal situation, you would not be asked to inquire in a way like we would here. But then, you know, you and I are on a mission, yes? So we will be engaging in questions which we would not otherwise engage in. Okay? So that's the first part. The second part is, see, what's going to happen is we'll finish from here by Friday night, and then there'll be some work between now and December for the participants. And then in December, you're it. You'll have whatever, 50, 60 people around you in a room like this. And while we'll be here transmitting live and doing whatever we can from here, but really who's going to be there in your center is you. So if I gave you something which is pre-cooked and say, okay, deal with it, it's not yours. And you know, I just got a list of all the participants, okay? And I just made a rough estimate, and I think there's over 1,000 years of experience in this room put together. Okay? So you want to just trust that, and you want to begin to do the work that's required so that by December you are ready to be able to deliver for the requirements of the mission. And at that point in time, you will be the person who will be leading in your center as the mission leader. Everybody with me? In case that's not clear, I mean, I can do other things to make it clear. How many of you have seen the movie Jab We Met? Jab We Met? Oh, it's a lovely movie. If you haven't seen it, you must see it. So one place in time, Kareena Kapoor is telling the ticket checker, okay, ticket examiner, the TT, she's saying, so, you know, he couldn't get, he's not well, and she's talking and talking and talking, and at some point in time, she says, are you convinced or should I keep talking? Okay, so I'm going to do that sometimes here. I'll say, are you convinced? Because sometimes I don't know whether you're already convinced and I'm just going overboard. So I'll just ask you, if you're convinced and you say yes, then I'll just move on to the next thing. Okay, so about this being a mission leader, are you convinced? Yes. Okay, excellent, then let's move on. Somebody said no or something? Okay. By the way, Indian way of dealing with yes is, you know what? No, let's not, you know, normal yes is yes. Normal no is this. Indian is, depending on the question. All right, very good. All right, so we will do the work, okay? We will actually get down to the design of your sessions for December. Especially these two sessions. Today's, so whatever we do today, okay, we're going to turn it into a module on Thursday, and then we will actually deliver on that. So you get to say how you will deliver whatever we do today on Thursday. Fair enough? So take, when I tell you to take notes, till then don't take notes. And I know some people who have learned how to ride a bicycle taking notes. I don't think they're in this room though, okay? Yes? Okay, good. So let me, this is, by the way, this is the second slide. This is the first slide. Self-explanatory? What color do you see? It says yellow though, right? Okay, in blue light, I don't know, there's something going on. So let's just orient ourselves towards dealing with this dilemma for the entire 2.5 hours. Okay, and at the end of it, I might ask you, I didn't really know what title to give this talk. So some of the work we do today and some of the work we do on Thursday, we collectively, jointly be able to say, okay, this is what we should call this module. Fair enough? Ready to play, huh? I know. I am. All right. Two agenda items. Okay, first of all, I want to acknowledge, there's a project called the Hunger Project. I'll share a quotation from there. I want to acknowledge that. I also want to acknowledge Landmark Education, where I trained for many, many years. So I wasn't like this before. When I was born, you should check with my mother. Okay, I wasn't like this at all. Okay, at the same time, there's a time when I got into some kind of a mission mode, and then I got coaching for it. And so Landmark Education is where I got. So a lot of, you know, everything that I'm going to be saying in some way or form coming from the training I got at Landmark Education. So I acknowledge that as my source. Okay, all right. You got the last part. Yeah, okay. So I put this in quotations, students, I don't know what else to say, audience, I don't know what else to say. So therefore I put it in quotations, all right? So you know that I cannot do this work without the generosity of your listening. You know I can't go to the railway station over here and says, come, I'll show you green and blue light. You know, they'll think I'm, and put me in an asylum, yes? So we get to do this because we're all mad together. You can't do that otherwise. You understand? So I'm very sure that the work that's going to get done is going to get done because of the generous listening that you provide for the mission to get accomplished. Everybody with me? Okay. Ready? Okay, I request your kind permission to share some experiments in teaching. These are just experiments in teaching, okay? This is some things that we've been doing in the communication skills course, some of the other courses. So the entire team, Professor Sundar, Professor Sachin Patwardhan, Ashish Pandey, Professor Partha Sarthi, all the people who are going to, we've actually been playing this game for a few years now. So therefore, we're just going to share some of the things that we've been doing, okay? There's no other agenda other than sharing. However, I require your permission. Okay, no, but granted, watch, granted. You know, I'm setting you up. You have any idea how badly I'm setting you up? Watch, okay, wait. All right, so, you know, permission, right? Question. We'll be doing some. Okay. All right, and insurance may not be required, but consent is. We've done this many times, and we've never had the need to call an ambulance at the end of this session. So that way you're okay, all right? But I need your permission, okay? So I'm assuming that permission. If at any point in time you feel you do not have, you're not giving me that permission, you just raise and say, no permission, that separately, I have a here, right, adjacent over here, soundproof. I mean, you want to be on a mission and you want to take permission, come to me. All in fun, okay? Everybody? Okay, good. But somewhere the fun will end and I'll really begin, all right? So everybody got the smiling face and all? Yeah? Okay, good. So the nature of the work today, okay? No knowledge. Okay? I'm not going to be doing any work on knowledge. I'm not going to be doing any work on information. Okay? Nothing for me to give you. You already have it. Okay? There's nothing really for me to give you. However, the nature of the work is that it's for us to bring forth that which is already there where you are. You know, where you are is in your chair. Okay? So it's already there. The work we're going to be doing is bringing it forth. Okay? All right. At worst, we will be left. If, see, listen, if there's no knowledge, no information, thing for me to give you, then whatever, nothing happens, worst come to worst, stories and entertainment. You're not serious. No permission for entertainment here, is it? It's okay, right? It's perfectly okay. All right. What is also available? What is also available is that every molecule in your body could reorient itself to a new you. Okay? You will have to choose between entertainment and the new you. No, no, don't rush into it. Listen, you have no idea how much I'm setting you up. Very enthusiastically, new you, new you. Very soon it'll be woo, woo, woo. All right? So you will have to choose. So I'm actually going to let this be a pregnant pause. Let you choose. You can choose. Can you choose between the two? Or you might say, let me see which way it goes. Some point in time, I will choose. Really, that's fine too. That's perfectly okay. Everybody know Santa Singh? Anybody not know Santa Singh? All right. I have a whole website on, you know that, right? On Santa Singh? Everybody know Santa Singh? Yeah, okay, very good. So Santa Singh. You know there's a Santa Singh in each one of us? You know that, right? Yeah, each one of us has a Santa Singh. All right, so I'm sure you must have heard this story, but for those of you who haven't heard it, let me just say it because I think it's important from the perspective of what we're going to be doing. We want to acknowledge and appreciate the Santa Singh in all of us, in each one of us. Okay? So Santa Singh, one night, under a lamppost, is looking for something, can't find it, and suddenly, Banta Singh, you know Banta Singh? Yeah, his friend Banta Singh. Banta Singh, I think sometimes even people say it's his brother. I don't know whether it's brother or friend. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Let's not get into the relationship business here. So there, you know, Banta Singh comes in and says, Santa, what are you looking for? He says, I'm looking for my key. So he says, okay, let me help you. Keeps looking. And they can't find it. So then finally Banta Singh says, where did you lose it? He says, I lost it there. So he says, why are you looking for it here? He says, because the light is here. That's right. Everybody's laughing. Yeah. Santa Singhs, all of us are Santa Singhs, okay? So what we will be doing most of the time is we are looking for the key aspects of something which is important to us in a place where we can see, not necessarily where it is. Okay? Okay, very good. So when we're looking at our students, when we're looking at each other, when we're looking at training issues, our relationship is that of providing to fulfill on a certain deficiency. Students are a particular way, and we need to treat them a particular way. So we are the ones who are providing something. So to a large extent, the relationship is determined by deficiency. It's a remedial in nature also, especially the weak students. Everybody know the weak students? Oh, so many of us have so many weak students, right? So therefore, something is called forth to us, from us, to be able to take care of the remedial students. So for watching TV, if you were to watch TV, do you need any additional effort? Anything required? The only thing you have to be worried about is whether the remote control has batteries in it or not. I think that's the only thing you have to worry about. Otherwise, you have the capacity to see TV, right? That's normal, routine. You don't need to do anything, yes? Okay, good. Now, if you were called today, you said, okay, there's an opportunity to climb Mount Everest. Okay, suddenly first thought is not for me, or, you know, but here's a call, okay, here's a call. And the question is, do you and I have the capacity to deal with climbing of Mount Everest as of today? Okay, so, but this call is not reflective of remedial or of deficiency. It's a different kind of a call. For this, most of us do not have the capacity. So the Mount Everest over here, the mission that we're on, is not about deficiency, not about remedial. something else is being called upon. And while you are the mission leader, somebody else is going to be fulfilling on it. And there'll always be a leader, there'll always be somebody who's, but then it's getting fulfilled jointly by the effort of everybody in. So I just want to point to that, because this is typically, I'm making some assertions, and please, you know, don't, if it's not mapping for you, let it go. If it is mapping for you, just take it in, okay? So, you know, we do operate in this domain. We operate in this domain most of the time, okay? So if the call is for this, you cannot go into this with these kinds of background conversations that are going on. We need to reinvent ourselves in a way in which it will actually fulfill on that mission, okay? All right. So everybody understands this business about doing the doable versus doing what is needed. A lot of times, you're looking at projects for our MTech students. You look to see, if you do this, if you do this, if you do this, it is doable. Yeah, okay, let's give that project. Okay, but if people from Maharashtra Pollution Control Board and the regional officers come and say, this is what is needed on the field, in the field, on the court, are we equipped to deal with it? Is it doable? I'm not too sure. Most of the time it's doable, but that's what needs to be done. So somehow I then have to shift what is doable, who's the doing, that will allow for what is needed to be fulfilled, rather than what I need to do, how to get it done. So mission usually is not in the doable domain, by the way. If it was in the doable domain, it would have gotten done. Okay? All right. So this one, of course, demands courage. It's not straightforward. It's not sitting in front of a TV with a remote control and it's doable. No, it's not. It requires kind of a human being, it requires redesign, it requires you to look at life afresh. Okay? And that's the nature of the work we're going to be doing today. Okay? So, you know, I'm just, you know, if you look at the students, right? If you look at the students, current context for the students is what? When they come for a class. If they, especially if it is, you know, 80% classes requirement, they'll calculate. When can I make the 81 so that then after that I can take leave? You know? I don't know whether we need to change this attendance to presence or something else, but you know, it just doesn't cut it. You know, so I really want you to begin to deal. That's why I'm saying this is now, you know, you gave me permission and all that, okay? Now this is going to get confrontational at some point in time. So I'm actually saying that needs to get done. How can you even tolerate it? No, we will still take attendance. I'll tell you what, I mean, there are reasons for it. Okay, but it's not because we are treating you as someone who's not responsible. You just want that. And you know, when we're dealing with students a particular way, whether the student comes or not, there are times when students sleep in the class. Okay, but I've also found out that they, for some reason, actually are listening to what's going on and do better in exams than people who are sitting like that. That's okay, let's not get into that. The point is, attendance is usually the context for people, for students to be attending. It's not when, you know, once they've joined, people come join. I did this experiment in civil engineering. We used to teach in the second year. Used to be a course in environmental science and engineering, so we used to teach this course. And this is in the third semester, okay, third semester. So I asked everybody in the class, there were 65 students at that, now there's, I think, 100 plus. 65 students in the class, I said, everybody, please close your eyes. So they would close their eyes, and I said, how many of you were really excited when you got through JD and you joined IIT? Everybody's hand is up, okay? I said, okay, put your hand down. Now, keep your eyes closed and tell me how many of you are still excited. One, two, three, not more than three hands. And this happened in more than 1 year. I did it for several years. Just wanted to do this experiment. So in 1 year, that entire excitement about joining IIT somehow is gone. Do you know that about your own self? Okay, when you joined the job, wasn't there like you were actually all the work to get the job, and then within a month on the job, you're looking for the next vacation. Not that you don't need vacation, please don't get me wrong, but it's like, do I have to, you know, you don't get up in the morning because you're excited about work. You get up in the morning because you set the alarm the previous night, and it rang in the morning, And when it rang in the morning, it's like, why do you have to ring every morning, you know? You set it up. I'm telling you, human beings are so funny people. Attendance, okay? So it's a requirement, yes, and there are consequences for not attending. Okay, so that's the background against which we are operating with our students. Okay, not to say about myself, not to say about how excited I am about going to class or teaching the same subject. Okay, so both, you know, the you are and who they are, that would make an impact. Right. Also, I didn't put it over here, but suppose you had this game in which you said that you will call out a particular number during the class, and if that student is there, they'll get a 5-star chocolate. Not very many people. Attendance won't change very much. Okay, but if you said, okay, you get 1,000 rupees. Changes a little bit? Huh? A chocolate is 5,000? I mean, how many chocolates you can get? No, no, you'll do some other, chocolate is not incentive enough for, you know, grown-up students, okay? 1,000? It'll change? You know, an American enters a room, a big hall, which has no chairs in it. Contextual, this is basically the contextual work that happens. So, you know, you got a whole room, empty room, this flat. So the American comes in, and please, and he says, where should I sit? And then the next guest says, sit. He says, where sit? Room. Two different people. The American for a chair, whereas the Japanese is saying, there's so much space. Where should I, which part of the room should I sit? Okay? All right. Just a couple of weeks ago, Professor Sachin Patwardhan was teaching a class, and the way we've set it up is that there's an institute lecture for 1 hour, and then in the evening we have 2-hour tutorials. Okay, that's the way it is set up in our institute. And so I was attending Sachin's lecture to listen in on what he was teaching so that then I could do the tutorial on that the next day. And there were people who came late for the class. Okay, and he said something very powerful. I'd never heard it being said that way. And he said, you know, most of us people from India, when we are abroad, we are related to as not being on time. Okay? And he referred to it as shoddy. It's shoddy. Like, you can't come on time. I mean, what's that all about? Okay? So, is that just an Indian thing? I don't know. That could be with regard to being on time. But then we're not alone. I think shoddiness is an adult human phenomena. And I said adult because I think children take a little while to get shoddy. Children are up in the morning. It's difficult to put them to sleep at night, okay? Everybody familiar? All right, good. Yeah. Be happy for them. You were once like that. So maybe let's take a look where the shoddiness of us collectively as humanity shows up, okay? The context we live from, okay? So, you know, there's a large part of India covered in this. By the way, this is a part of the Hunger Project document. And, you know, I've given some information there. So you're welcome to just say Hunger Project on Google and you'll be able to find documents related with it. Okay? So we live in this context, by the way. We live in a world in which this is allowed. Everybody with me? I know I just don't want you to go down the path of being burdened by it. You understand, right? I don't want you to get burdened by it. I don't want you to suddenly, the moment this paragraph comes in and we read it, there's a sudden drop in energy in the room. You know this? Everybody is in a different world altogether. So I don't want you to be burdened by it. But at the same time, I don't want to be, soft around it. And I mean, if you're talking about this mission here, if you're talking about this mission here, I'd like to know by the end of this session, what is your interpretation? What is your role in the mission? Because that's what we're up against, okay? The measure of this is infant mortality rate. I think Kerala is the least at this point in India. It's, I think, 70, maybe a little lesser. 50 is the acceptable norm for international. Okay? So you may want to engage to see whether that which you are out to communicate is at the level of a context in which this is permitted. This is inevitable. The way you and I, like I said, wars were inevitable. This is happening. Okay? This is happening in our reality. In the same reality, in the source document, one Erhard talks about, he says, against this backdrop, we are saying we want to make a difference. This is happening. When you confront this and you deal with this, it's like, I don't want to get up in the morning. It's probably, you know, a largest demonstration of shoddiness of what it is to be human. Again, not in a bad way. I'm not here to, you know, put burden on you of the responsibility. At the same time, you and I have to confront it. And it's not because there's not enough food, okay? That's not happening because there's not enough food. There's enough food. It's just we live as though that is inevitable. Whatever your version of that might be, somewhere, someplace, you accept something not working by saying, that's how life is. Yes, human beings? Human beings. All right, very good. So everybody say, hello, partner. Your own partner, huh? I mean, just like, oh, you. All right, for you to be actually be partners, why don't you talk to each other for a minute each and talk about what is it that, oh, actually, let's leave it. Why don't you just talk about anything? Okay, please say thank you to your partner. Give them a big hand. Please give thank you. Here's the thing. Why I've set you up is because the work that we're going to be doing is going to be with partners now. Okay? So if you were listening to your partner, like life, your life depended on it. And the person who's speaking it is speaking it in a way in which if the moment I say these words to this person, reality. There's a very sacred relationship here now. Everybody with me? Okay, it's not casual. It's one of those very committed kind of a listening, very committed kind of speaking. If that was the case, you'd suddenly become very careful about what's coming out of your mouth. Okay, because the person who's listening is listening in a way, no matter what you say, it'll actually become a reality. Whoa. Okay, so can you look at your partner one more time and say, okay. It's fun also, okay, it's like really magical, but it's as real as it can get, okay? All right, very good. So you got your partners. So here's something I want to share with you. And I've set you up as partners because I'm going to set you up for some exercises that you will then do with your partner, okay? All right, very good. So what are the obvious inevitables, okay? Death by starvation we just saw, okay? War on the planet, there's not a single day when the newspaper does not. In fact, now they have newspapers in which there's one small section which says good news. It's a very small section. The rest of it is not good news, okay? There's one small section which is good news. Politics, inevitable, inevitable. Not just politics. I mean, if I say to you, there is an honest politician. Why did you laugh? Why did you laugh? Because it seems like an oxymoron, right? Like, you know, how can there be an honest politician? You know, it's like the inevitability around it. You and I are so convinced that even if somebody were honest, it's just, you know, you got to be careful. This person is, we don't know what's going on. And of course, this one you know, right? I mean, you know there are no signs in the buildings in India? You just have to smell and you know where the bathroom is. And you and I are like, it's inevitable. And by the way, I said in India, okay? So there's a personal inquiry now that you will do in your notebook work after the next slide, okay? After the next slide. Did you notice the small red letters? I've found very, it's very strange, but when you write small letters, na, people read carefully. All right, very good. So, what do I take as that's how life is? There are some things that we take, that's how life is. And I'll just share with you some realities, some stories, two, three of them. Here's one. About 500 years ago? It's not too far, no? Just about 500 years ago, Earth was flat. 500 years ago. Just put yourself back 500 years ago. 500 years ago. 500 years ago. What happens? You take, naiya chali, jada aage nahi wapis aana. You know, right? Because you're worried about what? You'd go so far and then suddenly you'll fall, right? Okay, all right. So that's the reality that we lived in. That's how life was. That is one of those paradigms. It's in a way a paradigm that you'd undistinguish. Actually lives like that's the reality. Okay, here's an interesting story. There's this famine in Ethiopia, and there's some TV coverage going on, and there's this little boy, must be about 9-10 years old, and he is talking into the camera. The news reporter is talking to him, and you know, so he's being watched by people in all of North America. And one of the viewers, one of the people at home, she's watching this, and she just decides to adopt. This boy is an orphan. Okay, boy is an orphan. So she decides to adopt this boy. So she gets in touch with the TV channel people, traces the person down, sends the paperwork, and this person, this little boy, arrives in the US. He comes home, and he's standing over there, and he says, "What should I do?" So he says, "No, there's nothing to do." He says, "No, I must do something." He says, "No, there's nothing to do. You're my son." So he says, "I don't know how to do that. Please tell me and I'll do it." Last one, fish in the water. There's this fish which is having problems with his eyes. Okay? Keeps going to the doctor. The doctor keeps giving some vitamins. Vitamin A, I think, right? Yeah, vitamin A. Everybody knows, huh? Okay. Vitamin A. And started wearing thick glasses, you know, but life is not, because for the moment, for an instant when it was born, right, it actually had seen clearly, and then suddenly over a period of time, the sight was not so good. So one day this fish is floating near the surface of the water, and suddenly there's a strong gush of wind that comes and, you know, gets thrown out of water. Okay, it gets thrown out of water, and for the first time it actually is outside the water. And it looks down and it says, "Oh, water," and then says, "Oh, the water is dirty." And then the design of the fish is that it has to live in water. That's what it is designed for. That's how it is designed. But this time, instead of going to the doctor, he goes to the hardware store. Okay, gets a filter, puts a string on it, starts cleaning up. So as far as it can see, it actually can see clearly. So what's the difference this time? It's above the water, about being in the water. Okay, so you and I, human beings, are in the water, right? So we don't know. One opportunity over here is to be able to collectively see if there's a gush of wind that can come, and we can see our own, what have I been working on so long? Going to the doctor again and again. The issue is, I didn't have a mission. Maybe. I told you I have an agenda, right? Okay, good. So, instructions of notebook work. What is this? I have no idea what this is. Instructions of notebook work? Or maybe I'm just, you know, cautioning you or something like that. I think probably I'm cautioning you. Okay, so wear your seat belts, difficult inquiry ahead. It's the kind of inquiry which is not going to, the first three things that you're going to write are not the inquiry. The first three things that are going to come are the obvious, immediate responses that you would have. You feel good, you feel bad, you feel sad, you feel one of those things. And then after all of that, the real inquiry may begin. Okay? All right, good. So, everybody ready? Seat belts, you know? Okay, all right. Personal inquiry, and the inquiry is, what are the inevitables in flat earth? Okay? You're here as a daughter or as a son, do you know what it is to be one? Okay? The last one is, what is the dirt in the water that you as a fish are living in? Okay, good. So, 10 minutes of notebook work. Please pick up your pens. And this is the inquiry. So, I'll put it up, I'll leave it up for a while. No talking to each other. This is your personal inquiry. Okay, good. Please put your pens down. Look up. Okay, good. So, how was the exercise? Good is probably an understatement. Difficult. How many of you it is difficult? Raise your hand, human beings. Okay, good. It is difficult exercise. I told you, tighten up your belts and, you know, stay with the in the seats. And I actually had meant don't go to the bathroom also. Some of you here, thoda bathroom hoke aate hain. You know, no. When you are in this process, you go to bathroom any other time. When I'm going jabber, 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 I don't mind if you go. But when you're doing this work, nobody's going to the bathroom. Everybody with me?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. All right, now the more favorite part of this exercise is actually, now this is going to be a little tougher than this self-inquiry. So 2 plus 2 minutes, share with your partner. About this time specifically about the inquiry. Huh? Last time you were talking about mere ghar mein kitne log hain aur main kya karta hun, right? Okay, this time it is specifically about, and here's the thing, whatever may not be flushed out, whatever may not be clear for you personally, between the two of you, when you do the work, it'll get clearer. Okay? So work on that committedly, 2 minutes each person. All right, please go ahead, starting with 2 minutes now. Longer hair person goes first. All right, please say thank you to your partner. Thank you. All right, so I just want to get a sense of what's going on in the room, right? So I'd like one person from this side, another person from this side to raise their hand, be brave, and tell me what is it that you and your partner shared? Yeah, please.
So it was a very difficult exercise.
Yeah.
It hurt.
Yeah. Yeah. And I'm not apologizing for it.
No, no, okay, you don't need to. Actually, it irked the minds.
Yeah.
And somewhere we had to look deep into ourselves.
Yeah.
We talked about each other's maybe in-depth cravings.
Uh-huh.
Probably we could read each other's minds and take a piece of each other's own minds to know ourselves.
Okay. And specifically, was there something in your inevitable world that you actually got a chance to share?
Sharing on the sharer's part is a greater benefit. Uh-huh. I don't know how far the listener benefits from it, but the sharer does feel a little lighter and a better motivator in its own self.
Excellent. Now, can I do a little bit of work with you?
Please.
Okay, good. So I'm really not looking at the sense, the emotional state.
No, not at all.
Okay. So what I'm really asking for is, in this inquiry, did you see some places in your life when you're dealing with your life like a flat earth?
Yes.
Okay. Can you share that example?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
Two things that...
Okay.
I see that my flat earth is in India in this particular century.
I got it.
So
how many women here? Okay. All right. Got it. Thank you. Okay. All right.
A lady to manage so many fronts at...
No, I appreciate. Don't have to say anymore. We got it. Okay. We got it. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, women, got it?
Yes.
All right, men? Okay. All right.
And then the second question was that I'm feel as a daughter.
Yeah.
Because daughters take care of others' belongings as if they are theirs, not our own. We don't have a demand on the things. So we are more caring and more responsible towards other people's belongings and our own.
Wow. Okay.
So, and the third one is dirt. The dirt in the water, uh-huh. as a fish that we are living in,
okay.
is when we see...
First of all, do you know you're actually living in water?
Yes.
All right.
I realize that.
You don't need thick glasses and you don't need vitamin A, right? You know, how many of you have been working on yourself? How many of you have been working on yourself so that you can one day, someday see clearly? Come on, human beings. All right? So, what if it had nothing to do with you? What if it had to do with the conversations or the network of conversations around you and you caught up in that?
There are usually probabilities that it doesn't have to do anything with us, mm-hmm. but then it persists and you have to, it's consistently there and you have to live with it. You can change your own self, you can learn from the others and that's it.
That's it, right? So that's the itness, so that's the isness about it, ki yaar jeevan mein aaye hain to jeena hi padega, right?
Is tarike se hi.
Hai na? Aur uske next sentence hai na?
No, but the thing is ki aisi mein se apne these things.
Sentence kya tha next wala?
Duniya mein ya hai to jeena padega, ki hai zeher to jeena padega.
The whole tragedy around it too, right?
Oh yes, there is. Yeah. But there's a lot of happiness also because you are recreating your own self.
So hold on. You know what you just said? That's how it is, but there is also happiness around it.
Yes. Because you are actually recreating yourself.
Everybody with me? All right. Now, you know, she's doing the work here. And in fact, she's very generous that she's doing this work here with me. But you get the sense that we're walking around with this big burden and trying to make it in life. And also be happy, by the way.
Yes.
Hai na? A burden hi nahi hota to?
Aisa ho nahi sakta.
Aha. 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 Fish bhi yahi bola tha. Pani mein fish bhi yahi bola tha. Fish also was saying that. So I'm just requesting you, inviting you to stand in there. Stand in there and keep looking. And there's some more work to be done. There's some more work to be done. But for you to keep listening for how you yourself have come to settle in this is how life needs to be done, I will do it.
I'm looking forward
to it. Okay, excellent. Very good. Please give her a big hand. All right? Good. Yeah.
Sir, I have a little bit, as the exercise was difficult, my interpretation is something very different. I don't know whether it's true or not. Starvation is on the flat earth. I mean over here, the starvation in the context of hungerness, but hungerness is not for the food, but for acquiring knowledge, information, meaning thereby, you need to be a learner every time. There will be so many resources available. Difficulties will be there too, but you have to overcome with the difficulties and you need to learn every time.
And if there was nothing to overcome? But you know, you and I live like there is life in which you have to overcome.
Yes, sir.
So fondly and so lovingly you agree with it. And that's exactly what I'm asking you to look at. What if that is a result of the way we are looking? What if there was nothing to overcome?
Of course, sir. The resources are there and we have to utilize them, and that's why we need to.
This is like saying, okay, give me a theory book and I'll be able to ride a bicycle.
Yeah.
I'm asking you to get onto the bicycle. Welcome, yaar. Welcome to the exercise.
Thank you, sir.
It takes, by the way, you know why they're laughing?
No, sir.
They're laughing because they're recognizing themselves in you.
Okay, sir.
Everybody's having problem with this exercise. Everybody's having problem with this exercise?
Yes.
And, there you go. You thought algebra and, you know, differential equations were difficult.
Not at all.
Okay, what else?
The second one, only one sentence I have written. Whether I don't want to be a daughter or son, but I want to be a father, meaning thereby I want to be a facilitator in the classroom.
Excellent.
And the third one, what is the dirt in the water, meaning thereby being a fish, though I am a human being. Being a fish, the dirt in the water means there will be so many drawbacks and limitations in your personality. Mm-hmm. But it is only you who has to search for the drawbacks or limitations of your personality, and with the help of all the exercises available, you have to try to remove it from your personality, and then you need to be a find of transparent water fully without dirt.
Okay, and what if there was no personality issues and there was nothing wrong, nothing to be corrected, no remedial, no deficiency?
No, sir, I don't think that there will be
Can you get how real this is? That cannot be. That is not how life is. See?
Sir,
and everybody will agree.
But everybody will have one or the another limitation.
Little bit is there, right? But it's there, right?
Yeah, exactly, sir. Of course, sir. Otherwise, everybody will be guarded.
Interesting. Very interesting. And who said that was not so?
Sir,
who said that was not so? Wow, I mean, I hadn't thought of bringing this in here.
Yeah, I do agree.
Who said that's not so? The person you spoke to is that. When you were listening to him, you were that for him.
Yeah.
Who said that's not so? You'll have to, listen, you'll have to deal with who said that was not so. That may be so. How come? How come you're completely, outrightly throwing it out?
Yes, sir.
Then everybody would be God. That's how it is. Coach, telling you.
Yes, sir.
Deal with it.
Thank you very much, sir. I will try my level best.
We have such weak relationship with failing. Yeah? Either you'll do it or you will fail. But you'll only know you failed after you've actually given yourself fully to it. So trying is out of the question now. Nobody's trying anymore. You're either doing it or you're not doing it. You're doing it, you'll fail. If you don't do it, you won't know. Okay? All right, very good. All right, excellent. So, personal inquiry. How many times you'll keep doing this personal inquiry? I think I'm done with this, right? Everybody done with this?
Yes.
No, say no. It's ongoing. All right, very good. That's why there's this other slide, so that just in case you forgot, it's over, khatam hua yaar, chalo paper pack karke rakho kahin pe. All right, opportunity to share. You did that. Ready to go? Yes? For what? Enthusiasm. I like it. Okay, good. I'd like to actually have this conversation with you when there's no enthusiasm. Because this is a life-giving conversation. The moment you stand, any time that you, this the loss of power for you, loss of enthusiasm, you want to get back in touch with what your mission is. Okay? And start speaking it. Because in the speaking of it, it actually begins to take life. Okay? So, you're here for a mission? Let's just create a mission for yourself. Whatever your mission. Your mission. My son, 9 years old, keeps changing every day his mission in life. 9 years old. But he's very good at creating missions. How many of you, when you were kids, created missions every day? Pilot banenge, pani banenge. Pani puri wala no? How many of you love pani puri? Yeah. Okay. And how many of you actually have never considered it as a profession? I mean, it's a lovely profession. You should set it up. You know, you'd probably be the best engineered pani puris that ever got. Okay. Create a mission. Let's create a mission. Okay. At some point in time, John F. Kennedy announced that they would put man on the moon in 10 years. A lot of people said it cannot be done. How many of you have thought about something at some point in time and immediately what came up, or you even dared to tell somebody, you even dared to share it with your partner, and your partner said, what are you talking about? You want to become the next Gandhi or what? Yes? Some point in time you've been snubbed like that? Right? Okay, very good. So, John F. Kennedy, he's the president, right? So he decided, okay, if people are going to say it cannot be done, that means they must have done some committed thinking. You cannot say it cannot be done till you've actually done some committed thinking. So he says, whoever is saying it cannot be done, call them. Invite them. Because he put all of them under one roof to deal with that which needed to be dealt with. Because if they say, look, this is where you're going to have a problem. Oh, okay, that is a problem that needs to be worked on then. Okay? All the resistance, by the way, if you get people who are saying it cannot be done under one roof and say, okay, we acknowledge and appreciate what you're saying because you've done committed thinking, let's get together and deal with what needs to be dealt with. All the resistance that was there oriented itself to actually fulfill on a created future. Amazing power, right? And you know, in less than 10 years, man actually walked on moon. Okay? So there's a certain audacity in speaking the mission, in articulating the mission. Okay, so I'll just share with you something for myself, okay? You know, in the US, I was in the US for almost 13 years. And when I was towards the end, after the degree and all that stuff was handled, I was looking for a job. Okay? So what happens over there, there's the biodata, right? The CV or the resume. You write your name, you write your email, and you write your phone number, address, and all that stuff. And then there's a line underneath. And then after that, you write objective. No. Education, curricular, is all there. Not much can change over there because it's too late in life, right? That's already handled. So what you do is what over there is the objective, okay? Objective. And then, of course, you're supposed to use these choices of words, okay? I'm interested, I'm committed to working in a dynamic environment where my talents can be used maximally for the benefit of society. And somewhere, bottom line, I'm saying, get me a job. Okay, so I did that, okay? I did that, and every time, depending on which company you're writing to, you put in one or two keywords that will be of interest in, you know? Yes, yeah, okay, good. I mean, if you have written a statement of purpose sometimes, you know, yes. By the way, most of the statement of purposes I have seen till now are statements of motivation. They're not actually statement of purpose. It's like, you know, when I was a kid, when I was 5 years old, I saw a rose. On the rose, I saw a bee, and I realized pollution was so heavy in this country. Okay, and then, you know, it was further strengthened when I did my class 8th, I did this science project in which I got the best prize from, you know, the prime minister of, you know, whichever country, okay, like that. And then, and then by the time you got to the 10th, and by the time you got to the 12th, and by the time you finished your BE, whatever, you know, the pathway is, it keeps strengthening, and then at the end of it, I think your university is the best one that can give me admission. But where is the bloody purpose, yeah? So a lot of times I've told students, okay, now let's say that you already there, you've already been admitted, given, here's a letter of admission. Now, I don't know, you tell me. So after the fact, we can tell a lot of stories, okay? But I don't think we've ever gotten a chance to develop a muscle to speak it into existence and then fulfill on it. That's what leaders do. They actually speak that into existence and then fulfill on it. And does it take their whole life? I mean, are they guaranteed that they will actually be able to fulfill? No, there's no guarantee. But they get to live a certain kind of a life. The quality of life that gets lived is distinct. And by the way, if there is an interest I have over here, it's that you live that kind of a life. That you don't need alarm clocks anymore in your life. That you don't have to, this has to be a particular way, and there has to be, you do it all the time. It's just that you're doing it in very, very subtle, very, you know, nobody will know about it. Okay. So when you were born, the first thing, what did we say? What's the first sound I said? I didn't say cry. I didn't say baby cry. What's the first sound I said? The only difference between then and now is we've gone into the mute mode. So if I say, sorry, this lecture is going to get extended by another half an hour, guess what's going to happen? And of course, in the face of, yes, sir. We are very committed, sir. We are here for a mission, sir. So at least be straight about it. Now, you can walk up to this person and say, you said that to me. At least that's straight about it. Otherwise, very nice, Ashok, good to meet you and all that. You know, that's what we do. And internally, I'm going, meh, 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 yes? So unless you don't actually get that who we are by default all the time is, I can't talk to you about mission. I can't talk to you about, because your mission is what? I mean, your mission is not wah, wah, wah. There's got to be something going on for you to be going wah, 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 because you understand, right? So what is your mission if you're going wah, wah, wah? No, I think somewhere, don't hurt me, I survive, survival somewhere, okay? Survival, every time there's a threat to survival, it's going to go wah, right? Of course, the child is upside down and, you know, if the child is not breathing, you know what they do, right? Hold the child up, patak, you know, and then say, wah, so good for you. Now you live. All right, so, you know, at some point in time, I was going wah, wah, wah with my dynamic environment in which I will be able to give my maximal best so that I can fulfill on the purpose of my society, blah, blah, whatever, you know. So I was going wah, 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 really, okay? And then at some point in time, I said, actually, no, let me write what I really want to write. Let me just write. Let me see. I mean, if job was not a concern, if there's wah, wah, wah in my life for a moment, I'll keep it aside and actually write, what is the objective? What is it that I'm up to? What is my life about? It took me about, guess how much time would it have taken for me to write this? Any idea? About 15 days. Well, the first time I wrote it, I had to tear it up. For the second time I wrote it, tear it up. Third time I wrote it, tore it up, gave up. Slept, got up in the morning, wrote it up again. Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. But at the end of 15 days, when I read it, I cried. Why? Because I actually got who I was. Can you get that? That's the kind of power it would have. Okay? You'd actually be inspired by, oh, that's who I am. And just for you to know, within 6 months of that, I was back in India. Because somewhere in the background, my concern was job, my concern was survival, my concern was money. All those concerns were there in the background. Right? So that was actually holding me, and that was my wah, wah, wah in some sense going on. But once I got who I was, the thing for me to do was to actually get back to India and start doing the work that was required in India. That was my self-expression. That was my mission. Okay? So I'm inviting you to allow all the wah, wah, wah. Listen, you got to allow it. You and I are human beings. Allow it. Don't resist it. But just recognize it. When it's happening, when the wah, wah, wah is happening, recognize it. If you can't, you have your partner's phone number now. Okay, you can say, listen, pick up the phone, call them up and say, you know what, I'm going wah, wah, wah right now. Oh, I got it, go on. Wah, wah, wah. Okay, done, huh? Thank you very much. I've even told my students that, you know, they should always schedule things. You know, classes are there, you know, exercise is there. I also say, okay, at some point between 6:15 and 6:30 in the evening, every day, they should set aside time for wah-wah. No, you don't like this idea? I think it's a very good idea. It's a brilliant idea. 6:15 to 6:30 every day, or whatever your suitable time is. Okay? Schedule. For what? Wah-wah-wah. At least you are doing the wah-wah-wah, no? It's not wah-wah-wah doing you. You understand, right? Okay, you have some say in the matter. You actually have scheduled it. Anytime you have a live list next to you, which basically says, oh, wah-wah is coming, write it down. I have to do wah-wah about this. Oh, wah-wah, but I'll do it in the later. 6:15 is what it is scheduled for. So mission. 5 minutes, notebook work. My mission is dot, dot, dot. Don't worry about getting it correct because you got till December to get it correct. And then I'll give you more time after that. But you know, at some point in time, you will know. Because who you will be is inspired by that which gets written. And it'll call to you. And life will change forever, you know, at that point in time. Okay? So take 5 minutes. Please write down what is your mission. I'm not worried about what you're here for right now. Listen, hold up. Listen up, everybody. This is not about this particular course. It's about you. What is your mission? Okay, and this could be one of the expressions of that mission, but it's only a subset of, and you yourself alone know what your mission is and what your self-expression is. I can't give it to you. Okay, go on, 5 minutes, please. Okay, so thank you for doing the work. Okay, and it's just started, so it'll continue. Very good. So give a big hand to yourselves. All right, now your partner. Hello, partner. All right, now, you know, the most exciting thing to do now is to share this with your partner. So it's the first person who will actually hear. It's pretty special, huh? You get the point? It's pretty special. Okay, so to this person, special person next to you, share with that person the mission, or what is it that you're articulating? What is it that you see for yourself? So the person with longer hair goes first. All right, very good. So please say thank you to your partner. Yeah, you can clap. Yeah. Everybody know this is Santa Banta, right? All right, now you know this one. My partner's mission is, and I'm so proud of my partner. All right, so who's going to share for your partner, your partner's mission? See, I myself will be a little shy. I don't know, I'm not too sure about my mission. But if your partners listen to you proudly, they'll be able to say, hey, you know, my partner's mission is fabulous and I'm proud of it. So who's going to come up? Now I'll find out. Okay, one. Now, you know what? At this time, everybody's hand should be up. Otherwise, we're doing the exercise all over again. All right, we'll start again.
No.
No? No? Achha, so you, by the way, I like the way you said no. Somebody is asking me over there, you know, it took you 15 days to write, you know, how can I write in 5 minutes? I said, look, this is just a... I said, this is not the final thing, at least it gets you started, right? Now, the moment I say, okay, we'll do it all over again, and everybody said, no, you know, hello, I mean, listen, you're in the domain of practice, practice, practice. So you should be looking forward to. Sachin Tendulkar didn't get up in the morning and say, oh, another day. He actually picked up his bat and picked up his pads and actually got to the court. Okay? So everybody, will you do it again?
Yes.
It's a thoda vaheh hua na? No, it's okay. I mean, you should just know there was a little bit of vaheh, but the right thing to do is, ab yahan courts mein aaye hain, ye humare coach hain, waise bhi 4:30 tak ja nahi sakte hain, aap haan bologe to haan haan bolenge. All of humanity in this room. So you just want to look at it from the perspective of that when you are the mission leader in your center, who are you going to be dealing with? Human beings. You'll say, we'll do it one more time, and what will they say? No. And then you say, hey, that's not correct answer. The correct answer is yes. So to the degree that you and I have handled our own humanity around it, that's why I said, I want to start this conversation when there's no enthusiasm. When you're tired, when you want to go back and do nothing, that's the time when I want to have this conversation to see, are you really up to it? Because this, you know, I just want you to know, if this is not, I'm telling you, the moment you write that at some point in time, when you read that and you're touched and inspired by who you are, you don't need me around. You don't need me around. In fact, people will flock around you because they just feel great because they're around you. Okay, so that's the opportunity. Okay, so who'd like to share your partner's mission? At least a glimpse of it. Yeah, you want to come? Who else? Everybody's hand should be up, okay? Really. Otherwise, let's start it again. This exercise. No, listen, you're not listening to your partner committedly. There's a conspiracy already. It's like, you don't say, I won't say. But that's the all of humanity is in that conspiracy, and we're talking about hunger on the planet. Obviously, all of us are conspiring, and it's not because we are bad-meaning people or we are, you know, inherently bad people. None like that. It's just that little, you know, I want that extra hour of sleep, because you know, once you have taken this mission on, sleep is going to step out very gracefully from your dictionaries. Okay. So, who'd like to share quickly?
I'm Kiran and she is Sandhya. My mission is to know about the real life purpose. What is my role on this world, earth, and on which way I am helpful to my society and land.
Wow.
Being a mother and a teacher, at what best that can I do for and also for my students in a good position? I really want to work hard to be yourself, motivated and motivate the youngest of the earth. I am so proud of my partner.
And you. Big hand for you. Fabulous. So would everybody please stand up and give her a big hand. Everybody stand up and give her a big hand, all right? Proud of you. Absolutely proud of you. Wasn't that difficult, was it? You make it sound so difficult. It was so straightforward, so simple, and came straight from here. Okay, doable? They just demonstrated it, that it's very doable. Yes? All right, ready for the next session? Okay, excellent. So, there are two parts to the next session. First part is we will actually practice what we preach. Okay, so the way we're going to deal with it is I need 10 volunteers who have a laptop and who have internet facilities, and I don't want any wham-wham around it. Okay, pakka, you have laptop and you have internet facility, then we can work, otherwise it's okay, not a problem. All right, willingness to play. Here's my laptop, here's my internet, but I don't want to play. I don't want that. Okay, the setup is this, okay? This is what we do in our class. This is what we do. We actually have students take on, these are the instructions. We say this is a flight, and to be on the flight, they have to have a valid ticket. Okay, these are the conditions of the ticket, okay? The condition is, they have to review one journal paper in their area of interest. I don't tell them which paper to read. They pick up whatever journal paper. They pick that up. Sense of the paper. In 5 slides, they have to prepare. Sundar, we've done the first pass reading, right? So in some sense, they've done the studying such that in the first, in these 5 slides, they'll be able to communicate to the audience the essence of the paper, okay? All right, then at the end of this 5 slides, there will be a slide where they will ask a quiz question, which these fly, if you've gone through these 5 slides, then they should be able to answer that quiz question. Your question over here has to be consistent with and lined up with, or these slides have to be lined up such that this quiz question can be answered, okay? And if they can answer it successfully, then if they can't answer it, then we have to start all over again. Okay, that's the measure of success. Total time is 5 minutes for the 5 slides. And then the 6th minute, you actually give everybody a small slip of paper in which they will write the answer to your quiz question, and they'll give it back to you. You take it back home and look to see, oh, half of them failed. So which means that, you know, you need to start all over again. Now, the other thing you have to deal with is that this quiz question has to honor the intellect of the person. You can't ask how many liters in a kiloliter. Okay, you can't do that. Okay, so it has to be consistent with the quality of the paper, the audience. So if it is somebody from class 8th or 9th, I will ask a particular kind of question. If it is somebody who is I'll ask them a particular kind of question. If it is some senior audience who are research scientists, I'll ask a different. So the question is going to be determined to some extent by the audience and the 5 slides also, therefore. Okay, very good. Bring the PowerPoint file on a pen drive at the next session. That's what they will do at the next session. And they have to be ready to present. So dress code. They have to be dressed like they were going for a professional setting. I know I'm wearing chappals and shorts, right? That's not. So at least they get to begin to see what is appropriate dressing and what is not appropriate dressing as a part of this exercise. Okay? I don't tell them what is right or what is wrong. But they get to inquire. They actually say, sir, are chappals okay? And then as you're asking me, yeah, if I were in the interview panel and I saw you with chappals, I would say no. Okay? So then they get the feedback. But I'm not telling them what they should wear and what they shouldn't wear. Okay, and especially some of the women students who come, I tell them, go talk to a colleague, one of our colleagues, a senior colleague, go talk to them about it because they'll be able to guide you what is the best appropriate, you know, for you as a woman to be wearing. Okay, so those kinds of things we do. Any of these instructions not met, any part of instructions not it's an invalid ticket. So it's also in some sense an exercise in following instructions. Okay, a lot of times people will make 6 slides and say, sir, last is only references. Okay, what did the instruction say?
Five.
How many slides are there? 6. Invalid. How many of you know about parachute jumping? Parachute jumping? Well, apparently, when you go parachute jumping, the actual jump from the plane actually landing is not more than 7, 8, 10 minutes. You know how much time you actually take to pack your own parachute? It takes 8 hours of practice and practice and practice. And who packs your own parachute? You. And if you don't pack it correctly and you jump, okay, so instructions. I mean, I actually use this example to say, listen, just follow the instructions. One place, you know, this PPT. Sir, it is PPTX. But you know, I walked into the ministry, all the systems can only deal with PPT. They don't have provision for PPTX. So you're going to start, you know, messing around with your animation, all your tables will go haywire. You don't have the time. So if you don't have PPT, as they bring PPTX, by the way, what I do is I actually tell them, whoever has not followed instructions, inside of honor, there's nothing wrong, I'll arrange for an alternate flight for you. We'll arrange for an alternate flight for you. But this is for you to be able to say who followed the instructions and who didn't follow the instructions. Okay? Out of 350 students at the end, I usually have only about 30 students left. 320 or did not follow the instruction. One instruction, a little bit, but I'm not telling them whether they follow the instruction or not. See, this is a part of their own growth and development to take responsibility for, I didn't take that instruction into account. Okay? So a lot of them go out because they're wearing jeans. A lot of them go out because they're wearing chappals. A lot of them go out because they're wearing a t-shirt. Of course, there are people who say, what's the problem with the t-shirt? No, not a problem at all. Absolutely no problem at all. But the student himself or herself gets to decide what is appropriate and not appropriate. This is an inquiry. This is an engagement to be able to answer that question. Because tomorrow they'll be going for an interview. At that point in time, and you know, I even tell them, between, you know, we did that, you know, when we were students. Between us, we would have one pair of good shoes. We couldn't afford it, na? So, okay, when is your interview? Okay, so I'll come out, you take my shoes like that, okay. So people do that. They actually do the work that is required so that when they walk in, they're walking responsibly for having taken care of the instructions, okay? All right, very good. Okay, good. So this part over here, I said, so I request for some assistance. Yes? Okay, I don't know what to title. I don't know, whatever conversation we had today, what title do you want to give it? Okay, so some of you got some things, other people got something else. Collectively, there'd be some learnings, okay? So if you said, okay, let's align on these 3 things we want to communicate, then we will orient ourselves for the session and the tutorial accordingly, okay? So there's work to be done in terms of the level of design now. You're not the consumer now. Hello, everybody? You're not the consumer. You are now a co-creator in this. Everybody, got it? Okay, very good. All right, thank you. And you got the footnote there? Yes? All right, and the last thing I want to say, okay, last thing is, get a coach. They are all around you all the time. Recognize them, honor them, make promises to them. Martina Navratilova, everybody know, heard of her? The famous tennis player? Okay, I happened to meet with her coach at some point in time. And I asked her, I said, work with Martina. And she said, it doesn't matter what I say to her as a coach. She turns it into... It doesn't matter what I say to her as coach. She's such a great player that she'll turn whatever I say into gold. So thank you for being great players. I got one more minute. So who'd like to share something?
as you asked the question, what you learned from this today. So I learned that how to open up yourself, first point. Second thing is how to make things easier and so that everyone can enjoy it and learn from it.
Beautiful.
And third thing is, until there is no target, you will not try to achieve it.
Excellent. Yeah. Fabulous. Well done. Give him a big hand, please. Okay, who else? Anybody else from this side? Yeah, please.
If I want to say something on your presentation or what you exactly said, there are many things that we can learn from this session. First thing is that when we deliver a lectures or teach our student, we need to get involved them and even ourselves in the teaching. The another thing that I learned over here is that from this session that there is no limit to our growth. If there is any limit or any barrier, it is ourself.
Excellent.
So we need to start from ourself. And as you said that if we want to do something different from other people, instead of trying our hand again and again on the doable things, we should try to do something that is needed and means definitely that is beneficial for others. But here is the major problem is what we say psychological problem, that we do not try to unshackle ourselves from our thoughts, which we say that this is my limit, I can't do this, what you have spoken that, inevitable. So that can be converted into the reality if we try hard and if we have faith in ourselves. Like Swami Vivekananda says that faith in yourself can change your fate. Thank you, sir.
Fabulous, yeah, fabulous.
The way you presented yourself in the session.
Human beings, na? How many of you love to be appreciated? Come on, everybody. Yeah.
The way you expressed, it really made us think and rethink. Always this has worked in my life every time. And I think this will also work in future. And the real thing I loved is the way you presented yourself.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Yeah, please, last person.
The motivational speakers, Les Brown and Zig Ziglar, always say that nobody can do it better than you, but you.
Wow.
And I thought that, and I had a glimpse of a Zig Ziglar in you. I love you, sir.
Yeah. And you know, you just know, one of the things I'd said a little earlier was, the work that's going to get done is actually bringing forth that which is there already where you are. There's nothing here. Okay, so each one of you, whatever you're saying, whatever appreciation, there's something that you're recognizing yourself, and where it is happening is where you are. Okay, so can you just allow that and nurture that so that people around you, it doesn't have to be a particular, the moment you do that to someone, you have the ability to cause it, even if it is not there.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Thank you.